Good morning, YouTube. We're back out here. Took a week off. Did a little R&R out at the camper last week. We're back on the Monty. I left you off last week. We just dumped a bunch of primer on it. Went around during the week with a light because that's the thing. I get kind of blind after a while with the primer. But just nicks or areas that need attention, I just put a little piece of tape on them. I won't really know what they are till I get up to them, but most of them are little pinholes or little chips or something that needs to be feathered out, maybe. Maybe. Other than that, everything's coming together pretty good. I just wanted to share with you that it's a possibility I might be painting this in an actual paint booth. I have an opportunity to rent a shop which has a paint booth in it. If that pans out in the next couple weeks, I'm going to put off painting this till then. We'll see. I don't want to put it off too long because then the weather's going to turn bad. But if that works out, we're going to haul all the projects over there. It's a nice big shop, lots of room to work. And you'll see the videos coming from there. So wish me luck. Hopefully that turns out. We'll get some of the sanding done here first so that maybe it's just ready to go straight to the paint booth when time comes. Needs a little bit of work. Paint booth, the drywall is coming apart. There was a roof leak. I offered to fix that up. Get the drywall done. Paint the place. So hopefully next video we make of this will be me shooting it in a paint booth. But anyways, that's enough babbling and dreaming. Reality, we gotta get back to it and sand it. Gotta keep moving on it. It's not gonna finish itself. Okay, enough about me. Enough talking. Yipping, yapping. Let's get to work. See ya. Hey, Facebook. Sorry, no. YouTube! I'm getting you guys mixed up. We turn down the radio, it's YouTube. Facebook, we don't have to turn the radio down. We're blocking away. We're having a great old time here. Block, 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 sand, sand, sand. We're getting caught up on her. I wanted to show you something that I want to share with you. Some of you guys obviously know, some of you don't. Shop vac. I was watching, I think it's an Eastwood or Eastwick products video that I do how-to videos. He had mentioned when you're doing your blocking, your final blocking, this is one method I like. I sweep off the dust in between. Helps you to see your, I'll show you something else right here. Like, you know, your highs and lows a little better after you clean the dust away. But one thing he pointed out, when you've got little pinholes, you're just going to wipe the dust into them. Even if you're blowing it off, sometimes that dust is going to lay inside those pinholes. You're not going to see it when you're going over it with your eyeball and your eyes and you're trying to find it because it's full of dust. But your paint's going to show it. Now here's what he had suggested with a shop vac. Doesn't take any longer than it would have if you fired up the compressor to blow it off or, you know, swept it off, and no dust in the air. I like that part. But it's pulling the dust out. I thought that was a great idea. That way, you know, when you're going over with your fine tooth comb there, you can see everything. Just a suggestion, shop vac. Just as noisy as my compressor. Not gonna run it all day, but it's helpful. So anyways, that's all I wanted to share with you. Moving on. See ya. Well, it's Sunday morning. The dogs are out wreaking havoc in the neighborhood. I got a bit done yesterday. I had to quit. I was out here late last night. I'm down to 320, I think is where I'm at. Yep. Done around the whole thing in 180, and then switched to 320, went back around, softened her up a little bit. I got quite a few little breakouts here and there, but it's all pretty much straight. I still got to do the roof in 320. I got to fix these couple little wows I didn't like. But other than that, we're getting there. Yeah, I got to do that tail light. That one's done. She's all scuffed up, ready to rock. Today, I got to do this door jamb, the trunk, and the hood. Because I want to be able to prime the door jambs and the hood. And then I want to work in the engine compartment. I think I can show it to you. Oh, hang on. These hoods are not exactly light. Two hands only. But I gotta clean this up again. Now it's all covered in dust. We're gonna paint everything in flat black. I'm still on the fence about the firewall. Originally it would have been painted body color. I could see some of that coming through. But it kind of looked good if I do a line along the cowl and do black down. Paint the body color on the top. But it is going such a dark color that you're not going to see much difference. Would be one less thing that needs to be addressed while I'm painting. Might make it a little easier to get paint on it. Anyways, I'm babbling, talking to myself here. But that's today's project, I think, is to get this front section ready as well. I need to clean it up. Pull the wiring off, detail the firewall. I think I've got to take that AC unit off. Hopefully I can do that from outside. I guess it doesn't matter. Either way, it's got to come off. That just looks like snappers. Yeah, anyways, a little punchy. Didn't even wake up till 7 o'clock today. I was up all night watching, doing binge watching on Netflix. But enough about me. Let's get this car rocking. See ya. That's using your brain. It's what we call a one-man operation with a driveway that slants out to the road. Volt winch. Hopefully it holds. Okay, we gotta turn the sound down once again. It's YouTube's issues. Where we're at now. I got the car outside. Hooked up my handy-dandy winch-o-matic there and winched her back in. That's how you do it when you're by yourself. It is seam sealing time. I got some seam sealer there in the gutters. I gotta get that tape off now. It's been on there 4 or 5 minutes. Might be starting to skim up, but I just want to show you that's how I done it. I kind of gouged out the old stuff and then hit it with some 80 grit to smooth out what was left. And then pumped in some new seam sealer and smoothed it out with the old digits. That's simple, nothing to it. So that'll be nice and neat and tidy. I gotta get this stuff off though. Problem is, if I touch my phone after doing this, I'm gonna have this seam sealer on my screen. I don't know that from experience. I've got, you should see this phone. It's a company phone, but man, it looks like it's been through hell because it's in my pocket or I set it down on the bench while I'm doing this work. But gave the car a good wash with soap and water outside, power washed all the dust out of it, got all the jams ready. We're going to hit this with one more coat of primer just to seal everything off and then we're done. Unless I see a bad spot I want to fix. I won't be touching again until we get into paint. The only thing I'm going to putz on after that is the engine compartment. But this is it. This will be the last installment on this until there's paint on this car. I'll bring you back, you know, when I get something going in there. But till then, I gotta get out of here. I'll show you how I make out with the primer. See ya.
YouTube.
Hell with YouTube. There you go, guys. Just a note, this is a seriously large hood. Cannot possibly get it in one pass. So, unless I'm going to put roller skates on, I'm going to have to come up with a good way to lay it all out nice and even. But we'll worry about that later. Hopefully in a paint booth. So there's your Monte Carlo. I know this looks very similar to what the video was last week, but really not a lot of big things going on with this. Just sanding, priming. Sanding some more. Besides a couple little spots I noticed, this is ready to be scuffed in 400 and shot in color. So, I'll take a little time off from the Monte Carlo now. Wait on that paint booth. Hopefully that happens sooner than later. Have a good rest of the week, guys. See ya.